Hey veterans, Travis Studdard, Veterans Disability Attorney here. Today I want to talk to those veterans who have questions or concerns regarding what is the proper VA disability rating with regards to a heart condition that they may have that is service-connected. Specifically, there's several different ways that diagnostic tests can be used to rate a heart disability, but I want to start out talking to you about left ventricular dysfunction, which if you've been treating with your cardiologist, you may have heard, or you may have heard your doctor also refer to your ejection fraction. So let me explain first what ejection fraction is. That's essentially a measurement of the percentage of the blood that leaves your heart each time it pumps. So as you know, your heart is a muscle that constricts, it contracts, and then it relaxes, contracts, and relaxes. Every time it contracts, it's pumping blood out of the heart muscle. And then when it relaxes, blood flows back in. And what the ejection fraction is it's a fraction, a percentage of the amount of blood that leaves your heart each time it contracts. And there's several, the main way that it's measured is with an echocardiogram that your doctor will order for you. And this test and this measurement of ejection fraction is a general guideline for your heart function and heart health. So what is a normal reading for an ejection fraction? Well, again, most healthy people are going to fall in that 55 to 70% range for the percent of blood that's pushed out each time that heart muscle contracts. So again, you may see, if you're looking at your medical records, you may see something that says LVEF. Again, left ventricular ejection fraction. So an LVEF of 65 means 65% of that blood is getting pumped out each time. Again, that's right in that normal range that one would expect for a person with a healthy heart. Again, the lower the number, the more heart damage there is, the more weakened that heart muscle is, and it can't push out as much of the blood from your heart. So then VA, in their ratings tables, looks at the ejection fraction, and again, the lower the number, the higher the disability rating that you would receive. If your ejection fraction is under 30%, then you should qualify for a 100% cardiac disability rating from VA. If your ejection fraction is between 30 and 50%, then you would qualify for a 60% VA disability rating for your heart disability. So that's 160. Again, the next lower level of rating is 30% disability rating. However, at that point, VA does not use the ejection fraction measurement as a ratings criteria. Instead, they look at some other factors that I will talk to you about in the next video. And so you can check that out. If you found this video helpful, give it a thumbs up and look for our others on, again, other cardiac disabilities and how those should be rated by VA. And some of our other videos as well relating to VA disability compensation. Hope you like this. Check out the others. Give this one a thumbs up and see you next time. Thanks for watching today.